To create our histogram of user ages, let's start by using the qplot function. We'll pass it the variable age, and our data set is pseudo Facebook, so PF. And I'm going to add some color using the color and fill parameters. Running this code, we see we get our histogram. Now, you might have tried a variety of bin widths, and in this case, I think a bin width of 1 is the best. So let's add that in here. I chose a bin width of 1 since 1 makes sense since we're going by years or ages. This gives me a histogram of counts of users by individual years, so I can get a finer view of the data for, say, like 25 years old. By setting the bin width equal to 1, it allows us to more easily spot unusual spikes in our data. Points like here, here, and definitely out here. Let's zoom in on this plot and take a closer look. I see the largest spikes in the mid to late 20s, and we don't have any users reporting an age lower than 13 at the left of the histogram. This makes sense because users must be at least 13 years old to set up a Facebook account. Now, there's also some unusual spikes above 100, but my guess is that some users may be exaggerating their age. Do you have any friends that are 100 years or older on Facebook? I know I certainly don't. And one final comment that I want to make is that your x-axis might look slightly different than mine. Remember that we can use ScaleX Discrete or ScaleX Continuous to change this appearance. So adding ScaleX Discrete here, I can set the breaks so that way they run from 0 to 113 and they increment every 5 units, or every 5 years. Now, you might be wondering why I chose 113 here, and I have a simple answer for you. I just used the maximum age in our user dataset. Remember, I can find that out by running summary on that variable. So I can see the minimum age is 13 and the maximum age is 113.